work my house, but I still can't pay it though. But I got just enough to get off in this club and have me a good time before my time is up. Hey, let's get it now.
Ooh, I want the time of my life.
It's worldwide.
Oh, baby. Ooh, give me the time of my life.
Neo, hey, let's get it. This is the last $20 I got, but I'ma have a good time ballin' in that. Set a bartender, line up some sides, cause I'ma get loose. Tonight. She's on fire, she's so hot, I'm no liar, she burned up the spot. Look like Mariah, I took another shot. Hold her, drop it like it's hot. Dirty talk, dirty dance. She a freaky girl, and I'm a freaky man. She on the rebound, broke up with an ex, and I'm like Rodman, ready on deck. I told her I wanna ride out, and she said yes. We didn't go to church, but I got blessed.
Yeah. this. I can't breathe, it's burning through my chest. Oh, the fantasy, it's taking over like a disease. Pull me out of this. I can't breathe, no, I just need a rest. From Paris, you know I held on too much. I left you at the station. I put you in my
standing there on that lawn, discount shades, store-bought tan, flip-flops and cut-off jeans. Somewhere between that setting sun, I'm on fire, I'm born to run. You looked at me and I was done, but we're just getting started. I was singing to you, you were singing to me. I was so alive, never been more free. Fired up my daddy's lighter and we sang, oh, oh, oh. Stayed there till they forced us out and took the long way to your house. I can still hear the sound of you saying don't go. When I think about you, I think about 17. I think about my OG. I think about the stars in the sky. Funny how a melody sounds.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you.
Standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
You, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
Your way and the vibe is feeling stronger. What's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken. The love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side.
Come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you
What was your favorite high school memory?
My junior year, when Kevin Jonas added me on Snapchat in the middle of zoology class, and I freaked out.
I know my rent was gonna be late about a week ago. I worked my ass, but I still can't pay it though. But I got just enough to get off in this club and have me a good time before my time is up. Hey, let's get it now.
Ooh, I want the time of my life.
It's worldwide.
Oh, baby. Ooh.
Drop it like it's hot. Dirty talk. Dirty dance. She a freaky girl, and I'm a freaky man. She on the rebound. Broke up with an ex, and I'm like Rodman, ready on deck. I told her, wanna ride out, and she said, yes. We didn't go to church, but I got blessed.
Oh,
this. I can't breathe, it's burning through my chest. Oh, the fantasy, it's taking over like a disease. Throw me out of this. I can't breathe, you know, I just need a rest. From parents, you know I held on too much. I left you at the station. I put you in my
standing there on that lawn, discount shade, store-bought tan, flip-flops and cut-off jeans. Somewhere between that setting sun, I'm on fire, I'm born to run. You looked at me and I was done, but we were just getting started. I was singing to you, you were singing to me. I was so alive, never been more free. Fired up my daddy's lighter and we sang, oh, oh, oh. Stayed there till they forced us out and took the long way to your house. Still hear the sound of you saying don't go. When I think about you, I think about 17. I think about my OG. I think about the stars in the sky. Funny how a melody sounds like a memory, like a soundtrack to a July Saturday night.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
You, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
See you again.
We've come along.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand, take off your hats for the national anthem. This morning's performance will be the Chamber Choir section leaders, four seniors, the soprano, Caitlin Clayson, alto, Becky Wise, tenor, Stephen Evans Renteria, and the bass, Ben Parsons. The director is Joshua Rist. Fantastic performance by our chamber choir section leaders. And now we will have the introductions, and it's my pleasure to introduce to you student body president, Kayleen Wheeler.
As ASB president, I'm here to introduce you all to the day we celebrate hard work, accomplishment, and dedication. I introduce administration, teachers, and school board members to the moment where you get to see the students you have watched grow and prosper the past 4 years walk across the stage, diploma in hand. To all the families and friends, I introduce you to one of the biggest milestones you have been waiting to see the past 18 years of our lives. And to you, class of 2015, I introduce you to a new beginning, one that will be full of ups and downs, tears and laughter, and many joyous moments. The moment that still hasn't even hit any of us and won't until we're not allowed to come back here in 3 months. The moment we get to share with the classmates we have had since kindergarten and get to sit side by side with all the amazing people we have shared unforgettable memories with. We have prepared for this remarkable moment the last 12 years and have completed countless tests, assignments, and projects to get us here. As we all move on into the real world, keep in mind that hard work pays off, and there's no script to your life. So go out and achieve whatever you desire. Even though this marks one of the most important days of some of our lives, it's not the end of our lifelong journey. I introduce you all to this year's graduation ceremony.
Thank you very much, Kayleen. And now we invite, with the bienvenidos, Maria Almonte.
Oh, Hola, muy buenos días a todos. Mi nombre es María Almonte. Estoy muy contenta de poder estar aquí con todos ustedes en este día especial, no solo para mí, sino para todos nosotros. Es increíble lo rápido que pasan los años. Todavía recuerdo el primer día de la escuela cuando muchos de nosotros llorábamos sin querer decirle adiós a nuestros padres mientras que el resto corrían haciendo nuevos amigos. Todo parece como si fuera ayer cuando estábamos cerca de 3 pies de altura. Ahora miremos, 13 años después, algunos de nosotros mucho más altos y crecidos y otros de nosotros crecidos pero no mucho más altos. Nos vimos crecer y madurar, logrando grandes cosas, todos juntos o individualmente. A lo largo de esos 13 años, todos conocimos a gente increíble, algunos de los cuales ahora consideramos familia. Son personas que nos apoyaron durante los momentos más difíciles. Juntos nos convertimos en uno. Hemos llorado lágrimas de alegría y tristeza. Aprendimos lo que el verdadero significado de la amistad es. Logramos muchas cosas y nos convertimos en la clase del 2015. Aunque para ser completamente honesta, nada de esto habría sido posible sin todos ustedes, los padres, abuelos y toda la familia que nos motivaron a ser lo que somos hoy. Por aquellos que lucharon tratando de hacer que nos fuéramos a dormir temprano cada noche y luchando otra vez por las mañanas porque no queríamos levantarnos. También por compartir con nosotros los momentos especiales durante todos los años. Cosas como los conciertos navideños en el invierno, por venir a apoyarnos y animarnos durante los juegos, partidos, las obras de teatro, conciertos musicales, rodeos e incluso ayudar con la recaudación de fondos significó mucho para todos nosotros. Otras personas que también tuvieron algo que ver con lo mucho que mejoramos a pesar de los amigos, fueron los maestros y entrenadores que tuvimos. Gracias por tomarse el tiempo de ayudarnos a mejorar académicamente y por ayudarnos a descubrir las habilidades dentro de nosotros que no nos dábamos cuenta que teníamos. En honor de todos nosotros, me gustaría dar las gracias a todos los adultos que han contribuido y hecho una diferencia en nuestras vidas. Todos ustedes nos enseñaron algo que siempre llevaremos con nosotros. Así que una vez más, gracias por unirse con nosotros en este día y bienvenidos a la ceremonia de graduación de la clase del 2015.
Thank you very much, Maria. And now it's my pleasure to introduce, with the welcome speech, Taylor Katzel Bradshaw.
Welcome, Dr. Mayako, members of the school board, distinguished alumnus Stuart Allen, faculty, family, friends, and my fellow peers to the 2015 Hermiston High graduation ceremony. My name is Taylor Katzel Bradshaw, and I am one of this year's valedictorians, and it is my honor to give the welcome speech this year. I am so happy that you all could take this several hours too many out of your day to come and celebrate the many honors that these students have earned. I congratulate you on all of your achievements. All of you deserve this because no matter what people say, graduating high school is hard. So here's the thing, guys. It's about as far as I got. And then, because what more could you say in the welcome speech besides welcome? So I decided to take this time to write some of the thank you letters that I have been behind on because of grades and graduation parties. So here we go. Dear teachers, thank you for challenging me to be the best procrastinator that I can be. Yes, I did finish that essay overnight, along with this speech. Dear weird block, not block schedule, thank you for making my first emotion in the morning confusion, because I have no idea what class I have to go to today. Dear house classes, Thank you for making me stay with the same group of kids for 4 classes in a day, making me tired of those people that much faster. Dear freshmen, thank you for being the slowest walkers on earth. I congratulate you on your achievement, but honestly, I have a class to get to. Dear home ec a hallway, thank you for always smelling so good and making me hungry for lunch 9 o'clock in the morning. Dear ag rooms, thank you for letting me know what cinnamon rolls and formaldehyde smells like mixed together. I really didn't need to know that. Dear Wikipedia and Google, you're the real heroes here. You deserve all the thanks. Dear coffee, you're my real rock. Dear Netflix, thank you for being so enticing when I know deep down I have 3 essays and a PowerPoint due in the morning. Dear scholarship committees, thank you for deciding that every scholarship ever should be due on 1 of 3 days in the year. This is the true test of procrastination. And finally, on a personal note, dear Deanna and my little brother Chase, thank you for harassing me to put you in the speech. Here you go. I will never get that hour or two of my life back. Anyways, this year has been a memorable one. From our last Spirit Week, where we saw all those crazy outfits, to our last prom, where we danced the night away. I've enjoyed this year with you guys, and growing up with you for the last 13 years has truly been an honor. Congratulations on making it to your graduation ceremony. And family and friends, sit back and enjoy the extremely long ride. I am proud of us. So here's to the long nights, early mornings, and stressful days that are now behind us. We lived.
Thank you very much, Taylor. It's now my pleasure to introduce Principal Jocelyn Jones of Hermiston High School with the announcement of honors.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Buenos dias, senores y senoras. Welcome to the 2015 Hermiston High School commencement ceremony. We are here today to honor these students and recognize the fact that they've made it. And before noon today, we'll all be formally graduated. Before we get started, I would like to recognize several people for their contributions to all we celebrate today. Please stand as I call your name and remain standing so we can thank you appropriately. Dr. Fred Mayocco, Superintendent. Mr. Wade Smith, Deputy Superintendent. Ms. Bryn Browning, Assistant Superintendent. Dr. John Mishra, Executive Director of Special Services. Our school board, Chairwoman Karen Sherman, board members Jenny Holtis, Don Rankin, Greg Harris, Dave Smith, Maria Duran, and Jason Middleton, and our distinguished alumnus, Stuart Allen. Would all the employees of Hermiston School District, classified staff, teachers, and administrators, whether you are on the floor with our students or in the stands, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. All of these folks have worked very hard over the past 13 years, inside and outside of the classroom, to provide our graduates with the premier educational environment that has prepared them for their post-high school lives. As a district, we also recognize how important our parent partnerships are. Without your unwavering support of these students sitting in front of us today, we would not have been able to help each succeed. Would all of the parents and family members of our graduates please stand? The The class of 2015 is accomplished in academics, activities, and athletics. I'd like to take just a few minutes to share some of those accomplishments with you. In terms of significant academic recognition, this year we are naming 5 valedictorians. They have all earned a perfect 4.0 GPA, as well as their honors diploma. You can recognize them as they wear the valedictorian medal. In addition to those 5 individuals, 26 others, a total of 31 students, has earned their honors diploma, an indication that they have met the most rigorous standards by earning credits in a minimum of 12 courses designated as either an honors course, a dual credit course, an advanced placement course. Their course of study also spans at least 4 different academic disciplines. Each student has met or exceeded the Oregon State benchmarks in reading, writing, mathematics, and science, while maintaining a grade point average of 3.5 or above. They are identified by the honors medallions around their necks. 139 programs of study were completed. Program completers are wearing the stole color of their programs. We have 43 students who have earned honors recognition by completing their studies with a cumulative grade point average equal to or exceeding 3.5. These students are identified by the gold cords around their necks. We have 13 students who have met the standards that allow them to be admitted into the military in 1 of 4 different service branches. These students are identified by the red, white, and blue cords they are wearing. At least 6,171 college credits have been earned by HHS students just this year. With over half of our graduates entering their next educational experience with college credits already transcripted. In activities, the members of the class of 2015 demonstrated leadership and skill. FFA is sending a team to nationals with a senior representative. FCCLA has 3 state gold medalists and is sending 12 members to national competition. The Performing Arts Department demonstrated the best performances in years, including 2 drama productions, Fall, A Company of Wayward Saints, and the spring musical, Music Man, with 15 seniors filling out the cast. The music department had an outstanding year of achievements as well as the chamber choir, with 19 seniors participated in the state competition, along with 2 seniors to the state solo contest. The wind ensemble also attended this year's state band competition, sending 37 total with 7 senior leaders. The ASB members completed 1,920 hours of service to their community, collected 109 units of blood during their 2 blood drives, as well as led many well-attended activities, including homecoming and prom. HHS hosted 4 robotics tournaments, 1 league championship, with 8 students, including 1 senior, competing at state. This is not a complete list by any means, but certainly speaks to some of the great things the class of 2015 has accomplished. Athletically, 17 programs competed at the state level, earning 6 state trophies and 2 state titles. Our senior student athletes have played a major role on the teams they represented, and they will be missed. Financially, the class of 2015 has qualified for and earned over $3.7 million $1,000 reported just so far in scholarship funds. The Generation College Club and Aspire programs have supported and encouraged many first-generation students to take their next steps in education. The scholarship listed in this program represents only those scholarships we were aware of when the program was printed. Collectively, the class of 2015 qualifies as one of the finest in Hermiston High School history. Would all of the members of the class of 2015 please stand and be recognized? Thank you. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce Karen Sherman, Chairwoman of the Hermiston School Board. Karen?
Good morning to everyone. On behalf of the Board of Directors, I would like to thank you for giving us the opportunity to be a part of this very special occasion. Today is our day that we recognize you, the graduates, who have gone the extra mile to meet a variety of challenges and who've taken the advantage. Excuse me, I always do this, I get over it. The administration takes bets as to how far I'm going to get into my speech before I cry. I've only made it two sentences. It's a very short speech though, so we will continue. The graduates have gone the extra mile to meet a variety of challenges and who have taken the advantage of the many opportunities that have been given to you at HHS. It is my pleasure to acknowledge each one of you for your outstanding accomplishment today. This is a day of to recognize excellence. As I thought about this, I realized that this is not a celebration of one day, but should be seen as a journey that you've not taken alone, but one that each of you have experienced with many others along the way. Parents, teachers, family, and friends have all been part of your journey and have had a large influence and impact on your successes. Your journey has not been one that was traveled by accident, but has been the result of high intentions, sincere effort, purposeful direction, skillful execution, and hard work. As a result of all of this, your futures look bright and rewarding. A quote from Lou Holtz, a longtime Notre Dame football coach, summarizes well what you have accomplished. Ability is what you are capable of doing. Motivation determines what you do. Attitude determines how well you do it. My challenge to you today is to continue your journey with the same focus and determination that you have shown so far, and success will be yours at the journey's end. Again, congratulations on your great accomplishment of today, and my best wishes for a wonderful and successful future. Thank you.
Well, welcome. I'm Dr. Fred Mayocco, Superintendent of Schools, and it's my pleasure today to introduce our guest speaker. 25 years ago, Mr. Stuart Allen was sitting where you are, graduates. He's a 1980 graduate of Hermiston High School. Stuart played football, basketball, and tennis for Hermiston while he was here, and he served as student body treasurer and vice president. After graduation, Stuart attended Blue Mountain Community College before continuing on to the University of Oregon, where he earned his Bachelor of Science in Finance and Political Science. Later, he went on to study law at Texas Wesleyan University, where he earned his Juris Doctor degree. Stuart is a certified trust and financial advisor and an attorney with decades of experience in trust services and investment management. After serving in two of the largest national bank trust departments in Oregon, Stewart founded Allen Trust Company and Allen Capital Management in 2001. Allen Trust Company is the only independent trust company in Oregon and has since added offices in Washington and Alaska to better serve the firm's Pacific Northwest clients. Stewart is also an incredible humanitarian. He's traveled the globe, including a recent Mercy Corps humanitarian trip to North Korea. He also enjoys coaching his children's sports teams, including football, basketball, and tennis. And he has been happily married to his wife, Sarah, for more than 20 years, and is the doting father of Lizzie, who is 18, Carly, who is 16, and Clayton, who is 13. And we're pleased to have them joining us today as well. Please join me in welcoming our 2015 Hermiston High School Distinguished Alumnus, Mr. Stewart Allen.
Wow, it's pretty cool. Teachers, parents, and guests, school board, and especially the class of 2015, my name is Stewart Allen, and I'm a graduate of 1980. My uncle graduated Armand Larvey High School in 1944, and my mother, Leela, graduated Armand Larvey High School in 1948. So my Hermiston roots run deep. This is a picture of me in 1980. If you look real close, you can see a pimple right there. I remember that one very well. I was asked today to talk to you about me and my life and my experiences. A lot of folks don't know who I am, but I remember a few folks here. But I am going to take this time right now to take a selfie. I can't not do this if I could figure out my phone. All right, here we go. Everybody smile. There's me. Yeah, I don't do the selfie stick. All right, you guys smile next, all right? There I am. All right. And my wife, of course, Sarah. All right. All right, thanks for that. Have you all wondered what your life will be like in 35 years? Do you think your plans are going to change over time? Do you think if you don't have a plan, that's going to be a problem? You're going to remember this day the rest of your life. I sat in your shoes 35 years ago, and I'm just thrilled to receive this award and be able to speak to you today. So sit tight. Let me tell you about me and my life story. This right here is your last high school lesson. I also realize that I'm the one that's keeping you from those and getting out of here to spend your time with family and friends and maybe a party or two, maybe. All right. Things never change. So buckle up, finish strong, all right? Staying with me. So you have no more assignments. You have no more projects. There's no more late night studying. No more recitals. No more games. No more report cards or deadlines from this school. Right? So wipe the slate clean. But please, please promise me and your parents this is the last time we were ever going to see you in a robe at 11 o'clock in the morning. All right? So, by the way, I like the robe look. Okay, so now it's time to plan. Webster defines plan is a strategy. You're going to need to have a plan to live a meaningful and successful life. Believe me, you can do anything if you plan. At your age, I really didn't have a plan beyond just graduating high school. What was I going to do? When I was in high school, we were on our 54th loss in a row to Pendleton. Just think about that. Every year we get all fired up, and then we'd lose. Yet, last November, I went to Hillsborough Stadium with a lot of y'all here in the stadium, and it was the most amazing thing. It was so cool. So I couldn't believe it. And there were so many people there from the Portland area and from all over the place. It was one of the coolest things. So do you know how we won the state championship? The school board, the coaches, the community, the parents, and especially the players got together, came up with a plan, and executed it. That's how you do it. With almost no history of winning, we built these phenomenal facilities, some of the best in the state, and got it done. Yes, things indeed were different 35 years ago. We lived a pretty simple life. I shared a bedroom with my brother. Our little house had only one bathroom, which my sisters tended to hang out. My mom worked at a potato place, so we had potatoes every night. Didn't always have meat, but she tried. If I wanted to buy anything besides food, I had to use my own money. I had a job since I was 9 years old, starting with a paper route. Other jobs I had were mowing lawns, picking berries, framing houses, driving a swather, working at the cleaning crew at Lamb Weston, assembling and constructing irrigation circles, working at the Army Depot, mounting bindings on skis and selling guns at Sports Village. Remember Sports Village? And of course, 2 summers pitching watermelons. That was a long day. I bought my own cars, my own clothes. I didn't even have enough money left over to go seeing it at Spout Springs on the school bus. I love growing up here. It was a different time, though. Disco was all the rage. We wore bell-bottom jeans. We wore silk shirts. Lots of bad haircuts. There were no cell phones, no computers. If you guys even right outside here on the old high school tennis courts, 2 o'clock in the morning, played naked tennis. I swear. Cowboy hats, tennis shoes, and nothing else. Until, of course, the football coaches show up in a blue Chevy minivan, including Kyle Kennison, by the way, chase their naked butts around the practice fields, spinning cookies. The mayor's grandson got caught. They never did catch the other guy. Yes, it was a different time. But after graduation, I still needed a plan. My plan was to attend the University of Oregon until I realized I really didn't have enough money. So I went to Blue Mountain. I commuted every day, back and forth, continued to work, studied accounting. And then I finally earned money, enough money to transfer to the University of Oregon for my sophomore year. I got there, I realized it was a little bit harder than I expected. But I even took a non-credit class to learn how to study. And then at Oregon, I had to pick a major. And by the way, those of you going to college, the best major you could pick your freshman year is undeclared. Seriously, I think you should take a few classes, see what you like, and then wait, just wait on your major. You don't need to start off with a major. I also encourage you to plan financially for college. It's probably the most important part. You have to constantly work on your budget and how you're going to get through it all. Being strategic about it is very important. I've been to all 50 states, and I've been to 43 different countries. I can tell you one of the coolest places in the world is Oregon. We have great universities and great community colleges, and better yet, in-state tuition. My college experience was awesome. I appreciated being in college and felt like it was a privilege. I also met a new batch of friends. In fact, one thing you need to realize is that most of you have not met your best friend yet. It's hard to imagine, because at 18 years old, my friends were everything to me, and I couldn't imagine replacing them. In fact, I'm still very close to my classmates. You'll never replace your classmates, but you will change a lot in the coming years. My third year, I decided to change my plan. I switched from accounting to finance and found a way to double major in political science. I also found a way to study at the University of London, paying in-state tuition. I live with a family over there. That's right, age 22 years old, it was my first time on an airplane, except for a crop duster out in Butter Creek. I'm not going to talk about that. I went to school for 3 months in London. Then I spent 3 months traveling all over Europe through communist countries. This is 1985. Then down to Istanbul, Turkey. I ended it all with a two-week trip to the Soviet Union, Leningrad, Kiev, Sochi, and Moscow. I had to borrow money from a friend just to go. I slept on trains and in hostels. I ate Ritz crackers and pasta. In my view, traveling is part of a well-rounded education. As St. Augustine said, the world is a book, and those who do not travel only read one page. I'm not one to sit on a beach or spend all day looking for a restaurant. History is not learned by just reading about it. It's better enjoyed with interacting with the people you go. When you travel, meet the people. It's probably the most rewarding part. I had a blast in Europe, but when I returned home, I was broke and carless. But I had a new lease on life and its possibilities. It's time to modify the plan again. Not to worry, there are no problems, only solutions, right? I signed up for a sales job that took me all over the United States. I paid off my friend. I bought a car. I paid off my student loans, and I saved money for law school. It took me 5 years before I went to law school in Texas. Once again, I so appreciated the privilege of being in law school. In the beginning of my second year, I met my best friend, Sarah. I was almost 30 years old. She was beautiful, sweet, spicy, and she actually liked me too. Although I had no time or money, I had to find and make it work. She was the one. After 21 years and 3 kids later, it remains the best decision of my life. Remember the part about not yet knowing your best friend? Be patient. It's well worth the wait. You will change a lot in the coming years. I continued with law school and studied hard. I actually earned better grades in law school than I did in college. And I earned better grades in college than I did in high school. Let me repeat that. I earned better grades in law school than I did in college, and earned better grades in college than I did in high school. I don't recommend doing it that way, but I want you to know that it's possible if you work hard and you plan. After law school, I returned to Oregon. Sarah said I needed a job before we could get married. Found a great job at U.S. Bank in the trust department, making $24,000 a year. My title was administrative assistant. It was a great place to work, a great place to learn, and better yet, Sarah said yes. I didn't sit for the bar exam right away. Took it a few years later and passed it, and I'm still a member of the bar. It was a tough test indeed, and one of my proudest accomplishments. I use my legal education every day in business. I think it's a tremendous advantage. 16 years ago, I founded my own bank called Allen Trust Company. Many said it couldn't be done and that it would not succeed, but I believed in myself. I knew it would work if I planned. Allen Trust Company is a trust-only bank with a board of directors, capital, bonding, etc. That's right, we help folks plan for their financial future. In a few short years, I went from administrative assistant to bank president and CEO. Sitting in your shoes, I didn't even know what a trust was, yet now I'm running a trust company. I'm very proud of the work we do. We have a great team of diverse backgrounds, educations, and work history. We help folks navigate the complex world of taxes, investments, and budgeting. We do lots of charitable and community work, including educational causes and supporting foster kids. Throughout my personal and professional life, I've had some really amazing opportunities, and giving this speech today is a very, very high on my list. Today, June 6th, it's not only an important day because it's your graduation, it's a special day for America because it's the 71st anniversary of D-Day. D-Day was the Allied invasion of France. That was the beginning of the end of Hitler's destruction of Europe. In 1944, D-Day was the first battlefield of the Navy SEALs, called Frogmen back then. As a frogman, my father did a couple of tours in Korea, but never came home to a hero's welcome. Anyone see the movie American Sniper? Chris Kyle's wife and his son reminded me of me and my mother. My dad never mentioned much about his service, but his few quiet words still echo today. You sometimes regret the things you do, but more often you regret the things you don't do. He's not with us anymore, but I think of him daily. And I want to thank him for his service. Please don't ever... Please don't ever forget to thank a stranger or a family member for their military service. In fact, I'd like to take this time to thank those in the audience who have served or lost someone that served. Thank you for your service and sacrifice. Whether you're headed off to college, trade school, or the school of life, don't take shortcuts. You'll not only regret it, but you'll miss the journey where you will learn so much about yourself and the world. Don't ever, ever be afraid of failure. It's merely an opportunity to grow and to learn. Disappointments and shame happen way more often when you take the shorter path and abandon your ethics. I'm going to leave you today with a challenge. On Monday morning, get out an old-fashioned pen and paper. Write down what a perfect day looks like to you. Write down what every hour looks like from the time you wake up in the morning until the time you go to bed. Write down where you are, what you eat, who is with you, if anyone, the weather and the smells in the air, anything else that may make up a perfect day. Put this in an envelope and don't open it up until the following year. Do this every year. You'll see that your plans will change and that not all paths are the same. A plan is not a guarantee. Sometimes your path will feel like the scenic route. Your journey will be different than everyone else. But if you plan for it, I believe you will have a fulfilling life. Thank you for having me today. I hope this inspires you, as you've all inspired me. God bless you up. God bless you all, and go Bulldogs.
Thank you very much, Stuart Allen. I had the pleasure of actually meeting Stuart Allen about 10 years ago myself and played a tennis match with him in Portland. I don't remember who won the match. It was very close, but I do remember that he did play with his clothes on. I appreciate that very much, Stuart. And now we're ready for the diploma presentation. Graduating with honors, Kayleen Elizabeth Wheeler. John Keith Anderson. Class valedictorian, graduating with honors, Taylor Cherise Katzel Bradshaw. Kyle James Nalen. Graduating with honors, Abigail Diane Drotzman. Michael Scott Gosler. Graduating with honors, Madeline Odette Bartley. Class valedictorian, graduating with honors, Alexander William Myers. Maria Alicia Almonte. Caesar Cadenas. Graduating with honors, Caitlin Michelle Clayson. Daniel Justin Lopez. Graduating with honors, Kajal Davina Mishra. Stephen Otilio Evans Renteria. Graduating with honors, Helena Nicole Haynes. Graduating with honors, Benjamin Parsons. Rebecca Ellen Wise. Grant J. Trainer. Lindsay B. Anderson. Corey J. Adams. Biridiana Ayon Rodriguez. Rodrigo Ariano Rodriguez. Jessica E. Roman. Devin A. Badu. Hannah Brianne Colgan. Graduating with honors, Amanda Page Pollock. Becky Lee Alanis. Jose Manuel Ortega. Kylie King. Dylan M. Batai. Graduating with honors, Jordan Michelle Giordano. Dylan Jeffrey Caldwell. Ashlyn Nicole Beanblossom. Timothy Michael Cahill. Rachel Marie Merritt. Jacob Ray Constance. Andrea Iden. Chase Thomas Carvalho. Brittany Elizabeth Espinoza. Christopher Anthony Barrett. Brianna N. Hughes, graduating with honors. Class valedictorian, graduating with honors, Timoteusz Kishnowski. Lydia E. Scott. Nicholas Hutton Carter. Shay Marie Lovejoy. Cameron Joseph Cahill. Deanna Rachel Klombang. Chase Conrad Carlson. Jaceel Natalie Lopez. Armando Contreras Leal. Taven Renee Headings. Stephen P. Davis. Sierra Ellen Miller. Jacob Collier. Angelica Alarcon. Ivan Carrillo. Olivia R. Stone. Fabian Cortez. Jasmine Angelique Gutierrez. Landon Cade Clark Gamel. Graduating with honors, Michaela Renee Mangione. Sean Thomas Hoogstraten. Sierra Renee Simon. Jai Obadiah Cecil. Genesis Navarrete Campos. Christian Corona. Evelia Lopez Navarrete. Luis Miguel Santoyo Jr. Bailey Rianne Giesen. Graduating with honors, Noah Tyler Davis. Shandy Marie Britt. Stetson Dwayne Gilbert. Bianca Rueda. Javier Ruben Gonzalez. Angeles Padilla Villa. Giovanni Tomas Gallardo. Graduating with honors, Mary Catherine Baumeister. Daniel Elder. Ashton Ann Huber. Darren G. Dyer. Graduating with honors, Alinganoa Pitalua Alima Enna. Class valedictorian and graduating with honors, Tyler Scott Wadecamper. Graduating with honors, Athan and Lee Reed. Christian Clay Lynn Mendoza. Claudia Benitez Arista. Emmanuel Lucio Dominguez Umana. Kimberly Gonzalez. Jose Uriel Avina Munoz. Maria Elizabeth Ruelas. Julio Cesar Monclova Jr. Brianna Lee Kessler. Chase Madison Knutz. Abby K. Langley. Cody Josiah Kyle. Bruna M. Cucolo. Alan Humphrey the Fourth. Katie Preciado Sanchez. Jesus Alberto Hernandez Espinoza. Gloria Zeferino Ballesteros. Anthony C. Herrera Jr. Brittany Nicole Hayden. Keegan Joseph Crafton. Adriana Acevedo. Juan De Dios Fernandez. Saul Montalongo. Brenton C. Hughes. Tatiana Louise Brock. Class valedictorian, graduating with honors, Kyler M. McCammy. Anastasia Nadine Morton Thorson. William Thomas Kidder. Araceli Angel. Christian Martinez. Kayla Raiden Geisel. Matthew Raymond Salvador Lede. Daisy Risueno. Carson G. Lloyd. Deborah Jean Johnson. Peyton J. LaCourcière. Graduating with honors, Ashley Willow Mosier. Jalen Hans Lindemann. And now please welcome to the stage with the class history and prophecy speech, Madeline Bartley.
Standing up here now, looking out onto the faces of my classmates, I'm struck by how far we've come since we first walked into the school nearly 4 years ago. We were a lot younger, a lot less sure of ourselves, and as a collective group, a lot shorter. We came into the school as freshmen, underclassmen, the bottom of the food chain. We felt the way probably a lot of you feel right now. Tired, ready to leave, and just trying to get this thing over with. But we brought with us a potential. Some of it was more obvious than others, but we all had it. We took this potential, and we joined clubs, leadership, sports. We went into speech and debate, FFA and knitting club. We took accounting, marketing, and art one. And little by little, we stepped up. We made varsity. We became the presidents of those clubs. We made it into audition-only bands and choirs. We earned honors diplomas and completed programs of study. Over the years, more than a few of us made it to the state level of our respective activities, showing off exactly what our school had to offer to people all over Oregon. But our potential has flourished beyond just sports and academics, as we are not the same people we were 4 years ago. We've learned a lot about choices and consequences. We stayed up way too late and still went to class the next day. We suffered defeat with dignity and won with grace. While not everything went exactly as we planned it, we learned that we can make it through, if only by the support of our good friends. Now, 4 years have passed, and we are older. We are more sure of ourselves, and at least the most of us have grown at least a couple inches. I still see that same potential in all of us, ready to be ushered into the world. Right now, this room is full of high school graduates, but we won't stay that way for long. Soon we'll be doctors, chemists, musicians, teachers, and a score of other things. I can see that the possibilities for this group of people are absolutely endless. Seated in front of us right now could be the next J.K. Rowling or Tim Zacharias. I have the utmost faith that the graduates sitting in this room right now are going to make a huge impact on the world, as we have too much potential to do anything less than that. So as we leave here and move on with our lives, older, stronger, and taller, I hope that we continue to use our potential as much as we have these last few years. I hope that you experience as much as possible with people that care about you and work hard for the things that you want. And if you don't know what you want, pick something in some direction and work towards that, and eventually you will figure out where you're supposed to be going. If something sounds too good to be true, it probably is, and just because we all graduated high school and feel like adults now, it doesn't mean that we can eat ice cream for dinner. Above all, let yourself be great in everything that you do, like you've been doing at Hermiston High School. The class of 2015 has accomplished so much just in high school, I can only imagine the kinds of successes each of us will have in the next 10 to 15 years. It's been unforgettable to be part of this group of people, and I will always be grateful to have been a part of this class. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Madeline. And now we begin the second half of our diploma presentation. Graciela Martinez Santiago. Edwin Garcia. JC J. Barron. Graduating with honors, Tresson William Bailey. Alyssa Renee Torres. Lucio Ochoa. Graduating with honors, Jordan Nicole Smith. Jaron David Jones. Audrey Amalia Elva Martinez. Abraham Maldonado Arellano. Josie Paige Wilson. Andres Gustavo Mesa Mendoza. Jasmine Garcia Quezada. Oscar Mendoza Rodriguez. Adriana Claire Benham. Luis Alexis Medina Ramos. Graduating with honors, Bailey Lynn Bicknell. Tyler McCabe. Savannah May Diaz. Trey Miller Montez. Bianca Maritza Torres. Milton Nava Paredes. Fabiola Ambriz. Ricardo Mendoza Armenta. Tiana Cecilia Lum. Justice James Royer. Natalie Jane Helzer Pope. Tristan Lane. Haley Marie Basford. Mitchell Stewart Lincoln. Yesenia Navarro. Jesus Alvarez Ramirez. Brittany Ann Beinert. Damian M. Quirconi. Victoria Marie Gutierrez. Graduating with honors, Michael Andrew Potts. Sage Mariah Smith. Dakota Hunter Paola. Madison Shea Espinoza. Stephen James Nunes. Casey Blair McLid. Cesar Jesus Lopez. Darian Lewis. Garrett M. Nichols. Graduating with honors, Andy Mendoza. Matthew John Gilbert. Bobby Taylor Hoffbauer. Cole Michael Smith. Graduating with honors, Perlita Veronica Anzores Flores. Graduating with honors, Timothy O'Brien Swart. Graduating with honors, Brianna H. Wolf. Jonathan William Tolman. Jean Ellen Crumpton. Anthony J. Searle. Hannah Dionysia Quick. Andrew Logan Sherman. Yanelli Y. Ornelas. Adon Sanchez. Kaylee Renee Clayton. Jesse Quincy Rodello. Tristan Marie Allschlager. Julian D. Trujillo. Jennifer E. Williams. Jonathan Paul Kinsel. Nancy Jeanette Soltero Hernandez. Anthony Tapia. Elizabeth Marie Campos. Jonathan Rains. Morgan Knudsen. Daniel F.L. Robinson. Alexis Lorraine Cady. Sheridan Zumwalt. Riley Christine Hodges. George Ross Westfall II. Francisca Constance Ketterbauer, foreign exchange student from Salzburg, Austria. Nick Wang, foreign exchange student from Firenze, Italy. Valerie Baez. Christian Vargas Arevalo. Alexis M. Schneider. John David Thacker Jr. Madison Claire Ledbetter. Anthony James Green. Graduating with honors, Mackenzie Lynn Jewell. Graduating with honors, Dylan Kenneth Ernest Zimmerly. Abigail Sanchez Jaime. Sarah Elizabeth Surratt. Ashley Leanne White. Colton Ray Murray. Myra Denise Castillo Avila. Emily Rose Piper. Jocelyn Zulema Franco. Adriana Ramirez. Kaylee Ann Harmon. Rochelle Leanne Knudsen. Alice Olivia Konechny. Leslie Sophia Gutierrez. Gabriel S. Watkins. Shay M. Watkins. Megan Danielle Stone. Caitlin Ashley Benage. Graduating with honors, Madison Ray Welch. Zachary David Adams. Maria Avila Ambriz. Selena Marie Longoria. Yesenia Campos. Celia Elise Gadsden. Sydney C. Dirksen. Mo Phillips. Elizabeth Danielle Chatlowski Claggett. Ashley Dawn Sandoval. Ashley Leanne Banker. Ashley Joy Estabrook. Christine A. Bivens. Vanessa J. Thomas. Perla Vargas. Karina Lopez Meraz. Leanne Marie Warnell. Riley K. Mason. Brooke J. Sloan. Natalia Elizabeth Rosales. Melissa Romero. Maria G. Lucas. Garrett D. Scott. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have our final speech this morning. With the farewell and the turning of the tassels, please welcome Abigail Drotzman.
Hi, my name is Abby Drotzman, and I get the awesome opportunity to say farewell to the class of 2015. I would again like to say thank you to everyone for being here. Teachers, faculty, parents, family members, and especially the class of 2015. I would have never guessed this would have came as fast as it did, but here we are, sweating in these awful robes, just waiting for people to get done with their speeches that we're never gonna remember anyways. As we say farewell to this place forever, let's not forget what we all went through to get here. Whether you were the procrastinator that waited until last Friday to turn in your senior project, or if you were the one always on top of things, we can all take a deep breath because now high school is officially over. Today it will be hard to say farewell. Most of us have been here at HHS for all 4 years, and some of us have been going to school with the same people for up to 13 years. Today we say goodbye to all of our classmates, some of which we won't see until our 20-year reunion, when we either have a beer gut or a mom butt. We also say farewell to our favorite teachers and our least favorite teachers. We say farewell to underclassmen and them stealing our parking spots. We say farewell to Friday night football games, late night bus rides, to tardy sweeps, lunch detention, and getting our phones taken away because we were texting in class. There will be no more homecoming or prom dances, mud tug of war, bonfires, Mercer's art class, or drama productions. We say goodbye to all the new and old friends that were made. We say farewell to everything that made high school go by in a blink. But today isn't supposed to be about goodbyes, it's supposed to be about commencement. And commencement means new beginnings or new start. Today we welcome in new beginnings, new opportunities, and new responsibilities. The class of 2015 is going in all different directions. Some will be going into the workforce, some into trade school or college, and some brave young men and women into the military. We now must start acting like the responsible young men and women our parents hoped we would be, and the ones we were refusing to act like. Dr. Seuss once wrote, "You have the brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who will decide where to go." I hope you all take the high road in choosing to make this world a better place to live in by becoming a gifted doctor, a nurse, an electrician, a teacher, or maybe even a mayor. To the class of 2015, good luck, and I wish you all the best. Now, graduates, will you please rise and join me in the turning of our tassels? Congratulations, class of 2015.